What?
Jacob, good morning. Can you please teach us how we can date with social anxiety?
Sure.
That's good. Hey, what's happening? I'm Jacob Carlson, and back in 2019, I was diagnosed with social anxiety, and I'm here making this video teaching you guys what I learned in my own journey so that you can overcome this issue yourself. Now, to the topic of today is how do you date with social anxiety? My first and absolutely most important tips to you is do not date if you're having social anxiety. Work through your issue first and then start dating.
Bullshit.
Yeah, sure. Whatever. Now, step number one, you have to be realistic. When you're choosing someone to pursue, please do not dream and think about this special blonde girl that works at this cafe or that smiled at you this one time. It's a complete waste of time creating imaginary girlfriends. So please just ask yourself these questions. Is this a person that you've ever talked to? Is this a person that you ever had a meaningful conversation with? Is this a person that you have any kind of connection with at all? Is there any kind of interest both ways, either romantically or sexually? If any of these are no, then you have to make a move to find out, or trash the whole idea of this relationship and choose another target, my man.
You got eyes on this? Can you confirm?
Boys and men spend way too much time dreaming, fantasizing, and idolizing relationships that are close to zero potential to begin with. Step number two is choosing the right location. Now, if you're struggling with social anxiety, you know this is triggered when you're feeling exposed. You might be afraid of someone looking at you and judging you. Maybe you're not even thinking this, but you feel tremendous stress and physical pain when seen by others in public. For me, this was worse in daylight and in more open, wide area. And therefore, choosing a place that is familiar for you with less people and going late at night is key. I personally recommend just putting aside cafes and restaurants in the beginning until you're more comfortable with the person. Start off going for walks or hikes or something along those lines. Step three, you want to avoid groups completely. When you're dating someone, you want to shine. If you're struggling with social anxiety, you're probably still a great guy, you're probably still funny and kind and all of that, yet you're just really uncomfortable in group setting. So although there is nothing wrong with you, but you being uncomfortable in groups can come off as rude, or it can come off as you being careless to whatever is happening in the group. Now, although this is clearly not the truth, that's just how silence and withdrawal can be read. Therefore, going on one-on-one dates on safe ground where you can connect and present your authentic self is key. Step number four, asking questions. So yes, you want to get to know the person, but actually more so, you want to find out if this is a person that you even want to date. This is really important because you don't want to date someone just to fill a void or make life better. No, you want to find out if this is a person that actually holds any of your values. Do you guys have any of the same plans ahead? In addition to this, the more you can get the other person to talk, the better. When you're asking questions and showing interest, the person will feel seen, which makes the person feel more comfortable, which in return makes you feel more comfortable. Yes, you mainly want to ask lighthearted questions that are fun to answer, but also just throw in one of those. Where do you hope to be in 10 years? Step number five, being expressive while keeping eye contact. Now, assuming you're struggling with keeping eye contact, fear not. This is the whole point that you start with being realistic, choosing the right location, avoiding groups, asking questions and getting the other person to talk so that you can lower your stress so you can be as comfortable as possible to present your authentic self and keeping eye contact as the other person is talking. Now, if you're the one asking questions, you mainly want to keep eye contact as the other person is talking. This just communicates, I am interested in what you're saying. I am listening. Now, if you're the one that are talking, you can have much more wiggle room. You can look around. You can just, as you're talking and explaining, just be expressive and all of that. Now, if you're still struggling, then that's fine. Then you just have to go to the next step. That is, allow yourself to be uncomfortable. Look around and honestly, just do this. Move your hands, move around, like stretch if you need to stretch. Just let yourself not be static. Allow yourself to just get up and get some water. If it's building too much stress in your body, go to the bathroom. Even go as far as changing the environment. This is completely fine. You're allowed to do this. Say, hey, I just really need some fresh air. Can we go outside and talk? This is you being expressive instead of you trying to force something that you can't do. You're understanding the fact that here I need to adapt. That's just a part of the game. Now, if you like the content, smash that like button on the video and subscribe to my channel. I will be making more content like this, and honestly, I'm really excited to have you on this journey with me. So have a nice day, guys. Take care, and I'll talk to you soon.